Hello everyone, this is Dr. Adel Bandak, Professor of Anatomy and Neuroscience, Mansoura University, Egypt. Today I am going to talk about the forearm muscles. The forearm muscles are divided into two compartments by the radius, the ulna, the interosseous membrane, and the intermuscular septa. The two compartments are anterior compartment and the posterior compartment. The anterior compartment is flexor compartment. The posterior compartment is extensor compartment. The anterior compartment is responsible for flexion of the wrist and deflection of the fingers. The posterior compartment is responsible for extension of the wrist and extension of the fingers. Therefore, the anterior compartment is responsible for flexion of the wrist, flexion of the fingers, and pronation. The posterior compartment is responsible for extension of the wrist, extension of the fingers, and the supination. Regarding the nerve supply, the anterior compartment, the muscles of the anterior compartment are supplied by the median nerve, except 1.5 muscles, flexor carpi ulnaris or flexor carpi ulnaris, and the medial half of the flexor digitorum profundus, which are supplied by the ulnar nerve. Therefore, the muscles of the anterior compartment are supplied by the median nerve, except flexor carpi ulnaris and the medial half of flexor digitorum profundus, which are supplied by the ulnar nerve. Regarding the posterior extensor compartment, the muscles are supplied by the radial nerve and its posterior interosseous branch. Let us talk today about the anterior compartment. And in another video, I will talk about the posterior compartment. The anterior compartment contains 8 muscles. We can divide the 8 muscles into superficial group and the deep group. Or we can divide the anterior compartment into superficial layer, middle layer, and the deep layer. Or we can divide the anterior compartment into first layer, second layer, third layer, and the fourth layer. So we have 8 muscles, 8 muscles, 5 superficial muscles and 3 deep muscles. The 5 superficial muscles are from lateral to medial. This is pronator teres muscle, then flexor carpi radialis or flexor carpi, okay, carpi or carpi is okay, flexor carpi radialis, then palmaris longus, and then flexor carpi ulnaris, and flexor digitorum profundus. Actually, the flexor digitorum profundus lies deep to the other 4 muscles. So the first layer is pronator teres, flexor carpi radialis, palmaris longus, flexor carpi ulnaris, and the second layer is flexor digitorum superficialis. The 3 deep muscles are flexor pollicis longus lying on the radius, flexor digitorum profundus lying on the ulna, and the pronator quadratus extending from the ulna to the radius. So you can say, you can divide the anterior compartment into 4 layers. The first layer, pronator teres, flexor carpi radialis, palmaris longus, flexor carpi ulnaris. Second layer, flexor digitorum superficialis. Third layer, flexor pollicis longus and flexor digitorum profundus. And layer 4, pronator quadratus. Regarding the nerve supply, all the muscles of the anterior compartment are supplied by the median nerve, except flexor carpi ulnaris and the medial half of flexor digitorum profundus by the ulnar nerve. Regarding the arteries in the anterior compartment, we have radial artery and ulnar artery. let us talk about each muscle, or generally, okay? So regarding the five superficial muscles, regarding the origin, all of them arise from the common flexor origin. And the common flexor origin is the front of the medial epicondyle. So the first fact is that the five superficial muscles arise from the common flexor origin, front of the medial epicondyle. Second fact, all the five muscles are supplied by the median nerve except the flexor carpi ulnaris supplied by the ulnar nerve. Third fact, all of them flex the hand or the wrist except pronator teres because it doesn't cross the wrist joint. So what is the action of pronator teres? Pronator teres for pronation of the forearm. Each muscle has additional action, okay? Flexor carpi radialis, this one, abduction of the hand. Flexor carpi ulnaris, adduction of the hand. Flexor digitorum superficialis, flexion of the metacarbophalangeal joint and the proximal interphalangeal joint of the medial forefingers. Regarding palmaris longus, it may be absent. Okay, so let us talk about the pronator teres. This is the pronator teres forming the medial boundary of the cubital fossa. Regarding the origin, it arises by two heads. The two heads, humeral head and ulnar head. Humeral head from the common flexor origin, front of the medial epicondyle. Ulnar head from the coronoid process of the ulna. Actually, the median nerve passes between the two heads, and actually the deep head separates the median nerve from the ulnar artery. Regarding the insertion of the pronator teres, it is inserted into the middle of the lateral surface of the radius. Regarding the nerve supply, of course, it is the median nerve. And regarding the action, pronation of the forearm. Pronation or medial rotation of the forearm. The radius is the movable bone and the ulna is fixed bone, okay? So the radius crosses the ulna. Regarding flexor carpi radialis, this is flexor carpi radialis. Regarding the origin again, it is the common flexor origin. Common flexor origin from the front of the medial epicondyle. Regarding the insertion, this is the flexor carpi radialis regarding the insertion into the second and the third metacarpal bone. Nerve supply, of course, is the median nerve. And the action, of course, flexion of the wrist joint and the abduction of the hand. Flexion of the wrist and the abduction of the wrist or abduction of the hand. Regarding the palmaris longus, this is palmaris longus. Again, regarding the origin, it is the common flexor origin. Common flexor origin from the front of the medial epicondyle. Regarding the insertion into the palmar aponeurosis. Nerve supply, of course, is the median nerve. And the action, flexion of the wrist joint. And it may be absent. Palmaris longus. Flexor digitorum superficialis. This one. This is the flexor digitorum superficialis. It arises by two heads. This one is called the humero-ulnar head. The humero-ulnar head from the common flexor origin and from the coronoid process of the ulna. And the radial head from the anterior oblique line of the radius. Regarding the insertion by four tendons. These are the four tendons. They are inserted into the middle phalanx of the medial forefingers. Regarding the nerve supply, of course, the median nerve. All of them, median nerve, except flexor carpi ulnaris. And the action is flexion of the metacarbophalangeal joint and the proximal interphalangeal joint, and it assists in flexion of the wrist joint. but it is not the main flexor of the wrist joint. And then this is flexor carpi ulnaris or flexor carpi ulnaris. Flexor carpi ulnaris, again, the origin. The origin, common flexor origin. Common flexor origin. This is the humeral head, common flexor origin from the front of the medial epicondyle. And it also takes origin from the ulna, from the posterior border of the ulna. So humeral head and ulnar head. And actually the ulnar nerve passes between the two heads. Regarding the insertion, the main insertion is into the pisiform bone. So main insertion into the pisiform bone, additional insertion into the hamate and the fifth metacarpal bone. Regarding the nerve supply, this is the exception. It is supplied by the ulnar nerve. And regarding the action, flexion of the wrist and adduction of the wrist. Flexion and adduction. So regarding the action of the superficial muscles on the wrist, this is flexion. The flexion of the wrist is performed mainly by the carpi muscles plus palmaris longus. So mainly by carpi muscles and palmaris longus. So flexor carpi radialis, flexor carpi ulnaris, and palmaris longus. Regarding abduction, it is performed by flexor carpi radialis. Regarding adduction, flexor carpi ulnaris. Regarding the three deep muscles, the three deep muscles are flexor pollicis longus, flexor digitorum profundus, and pronator quadratus. Flexor pollicis longus takes origin from the radius and interosseous membrane. Flexor digitorum profundus from the ulna and the interosseous membrane. Pronator quadratus takes origin from the ulna and is inserted into the radius because the radius is a movable bone. So flexor pollicis longus from the radius and the interosseous membrane. Flexor digitorum profundus from the ulna and the interosseous membrane. Pronator quadratus from the ulna to the radius. Regarding the nerve supply, all of them are supplied by the median nerve, actually by the anterior interosseous branch of the median nerve, except the medial half of the flexor digitorum profundus by the ulnar nerve. So the flexor pollicis longus by the anterior interosseous nerve, the pronator quadratus by the anterior interosseous nerve, the flexor digitorum profundus, the medial half by the ulnar nerve, and the lateral half by the anterior interosseous nerve. Regarding the action, each muscle has a specific action. Flexor pollicis longus, flexion of all joints of the thumb. Flexor digitorum profundus, flexion of all joints of the medial four fingers. And the pronator quadratus, pronation of the forearm. So these are the muscles, the three deep muscles. Flexor pollicis longus from the radius and the interosseous membrane, and it is inserted into the terminal phalanx of the thumb. Flexor digitorum profundus from the ulna and the interosseous membrane, it is inserted by four tendons into the terminal phalanx of the medial four fingers, and then pronator quadratus takes origin from the ulna and is inserted into the radius. They are supplied by the anterior interosseous nerve, which is a branch from the median nerve, except the medial half of the flexor digitorum profundus by the ulnar nerve. So this is flexor digitorum profundus. Flexor digitorum profundus, regarding its origin, from the ulna and the interosseous membrane. Regarding the insertion, by four tendons into the terminal or distal phalanx of the medial four fingers. Regarding the nerve supply, the medial half from the ulnar nerve, the lateral half from the anterior interosseous nerve. regarding the action, flexion of all joints of the medial four fingers. Regarding the flexor pollicis longus, flexor pollicis longus takes origin from the radius and the interosseous membrane. It is inserted into the terminal phalanx of the thumb, and the nerve supply is the anterior interosseous nerve, which is a branch from the median nerve, and the action is flexion of all joints of the thumb. And the last muscle is pronator quadratus. Pronator quadratus, it takes origin from the lower quarter of the anterior surface of the ulna. It is inserted into the lower quarter of the anterior surface of the radius, and it is supplied by the anterior interosseous nerve, and the action is pronation of the forearm. And again, pronation is medial rotation of the forearm. And thank you very much, best wishes, and good luck.